back to Politics Unplugged. Lots of new faces in our state government this year. A new governor, an AG, a treasurer, all Democrats, all voted in during last November's election. We also elected a new Secretary of State, and we are pleased to have Jena Griswold joining us. And we know this is your first run at public office, so congratulations on your election. How's it going?
Thank you so much. It's going great. I'm honored to be Colorado Secretary of State, and we're working right away to make sure that we have the most accessible and secure elections in the nation, to continue to support entrepreneurs and small businesses, and also to bring more transparency to government.
You mentioned secure elections, mm-hmm. which has been a big issue for all over the country. So how do you guarantee that we have secure elections when we have companies such as Microsoft and Facebook and so forth that seem to have breaches?
Yeah, so we have some of the most secure elections in the nation. And one of the things that we do really well is make sure that our elections aren't connected to the internet. We have paper ballot that are voter verified, and then we do an audit afterwards to make sure that the tabulation machines are properly functioning. With that said, we have vulnerabilities. We store voter registration on a database, and there's other ways to access data that we want to keep secure. So what we do is we have some of the best and brightest IT folks in the nation, and we're doing cutting edge, innovative things to secure our information. But you hit the nail right on the head. It's a continual thing to continue to improve our security. We work with DHS, local private companies that actually try to penetrate our systems to make sure that we have the securest election system in the nation.
So it's a work in progress.
It's always yeah. is. So we have the securest elections today, but we always have to innovate to tomorrow. And one of the things that I'm really concerned about is the national state of our elections. You know, Congress needs to act immediately to modernize voting machines nationwide. In Colorado, we've basically already modernized, but there's states that are really lagging behind.
I know you worked as a voter rights attorney for President Obama. You have talked about expanding voter rights. What does that mean?
So I served as a voter protection attorney for President Obama's reelection campaign here in Colorado. And when I talk about voting rights, I think we just have to look across the nation to see that the rights of voters they're not fully completed yet. We do see voter suppression. We have to look at Georgia, Florida, Texas, the list goes on and on. Colorado should be a model of what democracy can be. So we're gonna continue to innovate. And for me, that means two things for this legislative session. The first is making sure that it's accessible to register to vote. So I'm proposing that we expand automatic voter registration, which will make it easier for more eligible citizens to sign up to register
to
vote.
So how would you do that?
So how automatic voter registration works is it actually already exists in Colorado. And what it is switching the burden from opting in to registering to opting out to not registering.
Okay.
And that exists right now at the DMV.
Right.
But there's populations of people, the disabled, elderly, working class people who just aren't going to driver's license offices. So we want to expand that system outwards so that democracy, government services is really meeting people where they are. So that's first and foremost. And second is we really want to end the era of long lines. We want to make sure that Coloradans, whether they choose to vote the mail-in ballot or go vote on election day, they get the services they need where they are when they want them. So we want to stop long lines on election day.
Okay, so your office is also responsible for such things as registering a business, mm-hmm. Charities, bingos, I suspect things that people may not realize.
Campaign finance.
Mm-hmm. And so what is it that you want people to know about your office that maybe they are not aware of right now?
Well, one of the things I'm really passionate about is campaign finance. I think that there's so much secret political spending that it makes it really hard for everyday people's voices to be heard in elections.
And what can you do about that?
Well, we can push transparency. So right now we are working with key stakeholders in the legislature, to make sure that we have more transparency in political spending so that our voices aren't drowned out by secret political spending. There's a lot we can do by rulemaking also to make government more transparent. Not only do I regulate bingo, business registrations, campaign finance, we also regulate lobbyists. We can make those systems a lot more transparent. So what I'm hoping to do is make sure that we are making a democracy that all Coloradans can believe in and really paving the way for Colorado to be a national leader and at a time when trust in government is just at an all-time low.
Jena Griswold, thank you so much for being here.
Appreciate it. Thank you for having me.
All right, back in a moment.